San Diego City Council members are quarantined after the city learned an employee who was at Tuesday's meeting tested positive for the coronavirus. Councilman Scott Sherman attended that meeting in person. He is now in quarantine. So that means we're talking to Mr. Sherman via the phone. Good morning, Scott. How are you doing?
Yeah, I'm doing fine, Paul. How are you this morning?
I am well. Your news sort of dovetails into the national news in the sense that you're seeing how infectious this all could be. So better safe than sorry as it relates to you and other council members, right, Mr. Sherman?
Yeah, I mean, the employee who tested positive, I mean, was wearing face covering the whole time, was at a opposite side of the room, which is well past the social distancing guidelines. But the protocols are what they are, so we're having to do what we have to do.
So you got the that meeting was on Tuesday. You got the news Wednesday. Where were you Wednesday when you got the news?
When at home, just got the news in the afternoon.
All right. So and now, basically, are you just doing everything you do from your home office? Guy, correct?
Yeah, and with COVID and with the way things have been, I mean, there's most everything's been kind of remote anyway. So I mean, it's not much different than what's been going on, other than not being able to go out and about and do some of the things I've enjoyed doing.
Is there any in the back of your head? I mean, is there any kind of a thought, a fear, or is this no big deal in your world?
Yeah, no concern at all. The only concern is I'm probably not going to be able to get up to the pumpkin patch to get pumpkins for Halloween as quickly as I'd hoped.
All right, fair enough. Hey, look, while we have you on the line, because we so don't frequently get a chance to talk, have you decided which mayoral candidate you're going to support?
Not at this point, if I'm going to even check that box. You know, I mean, checking the box when you're voting is something you don't have to do if you don't feel confident about either one, or you know, like in judge races, I don't know enough about the judges, so a lot of times I don't check the box. If I was forced to check a box, you know, because I kind of disagree with both of them politically, I've known both of them for a long time, and Todd Gloria has always been Todd Gloria. Flipped one side or the other, trying to pander to voters to power. Where Barbara has been a lifelong liberal, and now she's trying to convince people she's not trying to pull votes from one side of the aisle to beat Mr. Gloria. And at least with Todd, you know who Todd is. He's not going to change tomorrow because he thinks it might get him a vote. You know, too many times we see in politics with, you know, Nathan Fletcher and Mark Kersey and some of them, the minute they see that there might be a path that's tough for them to get to victory, they start changing who they've been and start pandering to one side. And that's really what I think is wrong in politics nowadays, is too many people are more concerned with victory and getting into power than what their belief system was supposed to be when they were running for office in the first place.
So just on thought authenticity, Mr. Gloria has been consistently a progressive progressive candidate. He's legislated that way. You're just giving him marks for being authentic.
Yeah. I mean, at least Todd is being who he is. He's not trying to change his stripes come election time, trying to get into office. And Barbara, if you look at her voting record and what she's saying now, half the time they're two different things. You know, she's talking about how she's for open competition among contractors trying to get city contracts. You know, you can be union or non-union. But yet she's cast numerous votes that says union only need apply for city contracts, which discriminates against about 90% of the workforce. I mean, it was so bad one time, the council formed a communications person for the council, and every council office has a comms person. So I said, look, this is a $150,000 salary, would be better spent somewhere else. And Barbara tweeted that she agreed with me, and then somebody had to remind her that she made the motion to create the position. But since it's a good soundbite and people don't look at the voting record, say what you want to say just to try and get elected. And that bothers me at the end of the day. I'd much rather have somebody who's authentic and I know who they are, where they stand.
In our last 30 seconds together, sir, your thoughts on Prop 8, which is the affordable housing prop.
Yeah, it's a $900 million bond that's going to cost $2.1 billion for the taxpayers to pay it back to build taxpayer-subsidized housing when we have models like Grantville here where we've changed some of the zoning and some of the processes to make it much easier to build affordable housing. and we're getting 30% of everything that's being built down there being affordable housing when we're talking about, you know, 10% mandates a lot of times. We're getting 30% just by the zoning and removing some of the restrictions that government puts in the way to building that type of housing. We don't need to put future generations of San Diegans in debt to the tune of $2.1 billion to build subsidized housing. We have models that work without having to go to the taxpayer.
So I can mark you down as a no on Prop A?
A very big no on Prop A.
All right. Well, Mr. Sherman, I appreciate you taking time to speak with us. Please stay safe and sound in your quarantine, and when it's safe to venture out again, we look forward to your face here inside KUSI.